we all please stand for the presentation of the colors from the Henderson County High School JROTC and the singing of the national anthem.
March time. March. Color guard. Halt. Order. Colors. Left. Face. Carry. Colors. Present. Arms.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free
right, face, port, color.
I hear a round of applause for Eddie Carlin, Dallas Morgan, Morgan Brooks, Caitlin Corsi, directed under Mrs. Audra Corsi. Thank you so much, ladies.
I'd like to welcome everyone to South Middle School. We are always very honored and privileged to host this event. First of all, I want to introduce my awesome group of educators that are about right in the middle. They're going to identify themselves in just 1 minute. On days like this, the word togetherness comes to my mind. And last night, those ACT scores of the high school came out. Those were some awesome numbers. And it makes me think. And together, everyone in this room played a piece of those scores. Pat Riley speaks of togetherness like this. There can only be one state of mind as you approach any profound test. And we are being tested every single year as the stakes go up. Three things: total concentration, a spirit of togetherness, and strength. I wish everybody a great year.
Good morning. I'm Julie Collins, I'm principal at Cairo Elementary School. And we, of course, as you know, have a totally awesome school. But that is really what I wanted to tell you today. I think, as I was getting ready today, I was thinking about the culture of school. And I realized that the culture of a school is a direct result of the relationships of the adults in that building. Wow, that's a pretty awesome responsibility, and I think part of that to me means that when life gets rough with us, and it does with everyone, it knocks us around, and we need that cushion of each other to be able to stand back up again and do the job that's so important in our school. You've seen those chairs for older people that lift you back up when you can't get up on your own? So maybe that's what I think we need to be, is those geriatric lift chairs for each other. But I think what we do is so hard, and yet so important, that if we don't support one another and be there and cushion and praise and appreciate one another, then we're not going to be the best we can be for our kids. So while we've all been about elevating everything we can for students, their achievement, physical, emotional, social, let's not forget to elevate each other this year and be there for one another. Have a great year.
I would like to introduce the superheroes of the 1199 South Heights Elementary.
Good morning. I'm Paige O'Neill, principal of Niagara Elementary. And if you didn't notice, we're here. A little ray of sunshine up front. So we're glad to be here, a wonderful staff at a wonderful school. Our theme this year is going global. We plan to communicate with students all over the world. And right now we'll say our pledge. Ready? Today is a new beginning.
I promise to be the best I can be, to go above and beyond what's expected of me, to listen and learn, be respectful and kind, to make good choices and expand my mind. I will believe, achieve, go beyond, and succeed.
Let's go, Niagara.
Good morning. My name is Brian Gardner. I'm the principal of A.B. Chandler Elementary, sitting in the back, my left there. It has been said that change is inevitable, but growth is optional. And we all know that we are facing a lot of change right now with new standards, new evaluation systems, new state assessments. It can be quite overwhelming. I'm so proud of my staff that Chandler Elementary has made it a priority to continue to grow and not become complacent. And so as I think of my staff, I try to create an acrostic. I love acrostics, but I'm terrible at making them. So I gave it my best shot, all right? I made the acrostic of leadership. Love, L is for love. Our staff loves our students, our families, and each other. E is for enthusiasm. Enthusiasm towards any new challenge that comes our way. A is for awesome. That goes without saying. Awesome. They're awesome. D is for determination. Whatever it takes to help students be successful. E is for engaged. R is responsible. Responsible for the lives of our kids. They take that very seriously. S stands for strength. H, happy, happy, happy. For you Duck Dynasty fans out there. I is for integrity. Doing the right thing even when no one is watching. And P is for persistence. They have a never give up attitude, and they do whatever it takes for our students. Have a great school year, and thank you very much.
Good morning. I'm Bob Lawson, the new principal at Central Academy. And speaking of that spirit of togetherness, thank you all. The spirit of togetherness, a couple weeks ago, I sent out an email request to close to help our kids, and we received an overwhelming response to that. So from all of us at Central Academy, thanks for that. This year at Central Academy, we're going to invest in the lives of our students, families, and of our community. Each day we're going to educate kids to the best of our ability. And in all our words and in all our actions, kids are first, and together everyone achieves more.
I'm Doria Buck. I'm the principal of Bingate Elementary. And at Bingate, our focus and charge this year is team and developing leaders. Last week, our professional development took us to the brain injury camp. You might have heard about that. No one got hurt, and it was a huge, successful day for us. We also focused on our book study of The Leader in Me. And at this time, I'd like to introduce to you Mr. David Drennan that created something on the cuff in 5 minutes that speaks to us.
Hello, Henderson County School District. Glad to be here. As a first-year teacher, I'm excited to get started and meet my students in the morning. I'd like to present to you the tribute to the Gator team. I am new to the Bendgate team, but I know we share the same esteem. To challenge students to leaders be, to be the change they wish to see. We have a mission, focused and clear, to guide our students without fear, giving them time to stop and think, building them up, not letting them shrink. Asking questions that are out of the box, looking past the orthodox, aligning new impacts with student need, giving feedback that is continuous, helping master content rigorous, expecting learning from all, from the pod to the kindergarten hall. Community groups and parents too are folks we need, to name a few. Improving attitudes day to day, sustained achievement our mainstay. Climate here is really great, but with these concepts we'll be in a better state. We are leaders at Bendgate, not leaving our tomorrow up to fate. Thank you.
One of our student ambassadors last year, whenever we were on the focus of team, came up with the idea of a call and response. So Bendgate, please stand. T.
Together.
E.
Everyone.
A.
Achieves.
M.
More.
Thank you and have a great year.
Good morning. I'm Nancy Gibson. I'm the principal of East Heights Elementary. And greatness, we all know, cannot be achieved without commitment. East Heights staff is truly committed. They're committed to each other. They're committed to their team. They're committed to their students and building those relationships. In the home visit list, they tripled students that they were able to make contact with and the families that they were able to make contact in just 3 years. They're committed to their craft. They're committed to their profession. East Heights staff, please stand as we applaud you for your commitment to greatness.
Good morning. I'm Miss Alicia from the Early Learning Center. I am going to read a quote from President Barack Obama at the State of the Union, February 12, 2013. In states that make it a priority to educate the youngest children, studies show students grow up more likely to read and do math at grade level, graduate high school, hold a job, form more stable families of their own. We know this works, so let's do what works and make sure none of the children start the race of life already behind. We had 300 parent surveys returned to us this year. 98% were satisfied and will enroll their children in the school. But there's that 1%, four people who said they weren't too happy. So I started looking through what were they upset about. Got to improve every chance we had. One of the quotes concerned that we needed to have a gifted and talented program. Leslie Stewart, if you're out there, you can meet afterwards. And then another one stated, I don't feel the principal does a good job. She spends too much time interacting with the children. We did receive a comment by email randomly this year that said, I wanted to thank you and your entire staff. Since moving to Kentucky from New Jersey, I was concerned about our granddaughter entering school and the quality of education, the education system in Henderson. To my delight, Your staff provided a curriculum and your tutelage that not only rivals but surpasses any in the entire country. What you implemented at Delma B. Johnson should be emulated around the world. My wife and I thank God every day for this in our community. So with that being said, we waved goodbye to 400 students in May, and we are welcoming 400 brand new families and students in just a few days. So we're all shaking just a little bit. But we live and breathe one thing. ELC, what do we live and breathe?
Every child, every effort, every day.
Have a great year.
Good morning. I'm Beth Watson, the new principal of Spotsville Elementary. We're going to share a little cadence that our students do. I know what I've been told.
Spotsville Panthers are blue and gold.
I'm a Panther through and through.
Soaring high is what we do.
Education will take us far.
We'll achieve because we are stars.
I've been told, so now I know.
Panther pride is what we show.
Roar!
Good morning. I'm Chrissy Sandifer, and I'm principal of Jefferson Elementary. I know how that feels because I was in her shoes last year as a new principal. I'm not going to lie, I was a nervous wreck to get up here in front of everybody. I didn't know half my staff yet, but over the past year, we have grown so much as a team and as a school overall. We've had the opportunity to have a lot of trainings this summer. We received the Leader in Me grant, and it's allowed us to do a lot of soul searching. Morgana mentioned this morning about having a purpose. We kind of looked in our souls and developed a personal purpose, purpose as an educator, and a purpose as a school. So our theme this year is leadership through and through, and we're excited about the 2013 and 2014 school year. And we have a little chant that was developed by one of my teachers, Ms. Laura Lee Steiner. Raise your hand. She's also really great at coming up with things right off the bat there, so we're going to show you how excited we are. If my staff would stand, please. Say hey, ho,
hey, ho. Just wave your hands in the air. We're teaching because we really care. Jefferson is our name. The set of habits is our game. Hey, ho, Jefferson Jaguars.
Good morning. I'm Chad Thompson. I'm the principal at North Middle School. We would like to wish that all of you have a wonderful year, and we are excited to open a new year with all the excitement and challenges that a new school year brings. I would like to leave you with a case about focusing on solutions that we encounter each day. When NASA began to launch astronauts into space, they found out that pins would not work in zero gravity, meaning ink would not flow down to the writing surface. The first solution was to solve how to solve this problem was it took them one decade and $12 million. They developed a pen that worked at zero gravity, upside down, underwater, and on any particular surface, including crystal, and in a temperature range from below zero to over 300 degrees Celsius. What did the Russians do? They used a pencil. The moral of this is always focus on the solutions, not the problems. The solutions lie within each and every one of your classrooms every day. Focus on your students, and the solutions are easy. I hope that all of you have plenty of pencils and have a great year. North Middle School is focused on our students, and we do have plenty of pencils. North, take it away.
In case anybody was wondering, they lined us up by age, so I'm left. And I'd like to introduce what I think is the greatest staff of a high school in the state of Kentucky. But I'd also like to pay tribute to everybody because we couldn't do what we do without everything you do. So if you're a kindergarten teacher or a middle school math teacher, or if you're an instructional assistant or a coach or a cook or a custodian or a bus driver, all of you have contributed to what our students can do when they reach the high school. So you're responsible for all of our success. And we would like to have everybody join us as we share our Colonel Pike song. And we've got a visitor in the back. We are the Colonel's
Apple Victory.
Cindy Williams and Ms. Danielle Crafton, who is going to share the HCS Leader Who Made a Difference in My Life presentation.
Okay, thank you. I'm Danielle Crafton, Public Information Officer for Emerson County Schools, as you can imagine. I just want to thank you all for everything that you do throughout the year. For those that are new to our school system, what a great job. I know that some days are hard, some days are victorious, it feels like, but let's reflect on what this means right here during the ceremony. This is what it's about. Last year when we did this, it was my first year, and it really moved me just working with the students. It was just such a special moment. And this year's going to be just the same. I spoke with the students throughout the last few months and their parents, and they're so excited to represent their school and to represent who they are as a student. So at this time, I just really want you to reflect on this moment and think about the upcoming school year and what you can do to impact a student, whether you're a teacher or a cafeteria worker, a transportation bus driver, whatever your role is, kids are watching. And that's what I noticed, that kids always watch what we do and what we say. So I'm so excited about this moment. I have been thinking about it for the past few months, and it's finally here. So with that being said, if we could hold our applause till the end. If the student has on the what they're about to display, if your name appears, wait till the end to come up to the front with your student. And if for some reason the staff member is not here, if the principal from that school could come up and represent that staff member. Also, I want it to be known that this reflects the 2012-2013 school year. So if the staff member isn't necessarily at the same school, we're reflecting last year, so keep that in mind as well. So with that being said, we'll go ahead and get started, and if you could just draw your attention to the screen and the presentation we have coming, it'll be great. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
my heart. Thank you.